7373.
Somewhere in the city, a woman can't sleep. This is a job for Mattress Man. Nevada Discount Mattress Warehouse, dedicated to truth, justice, and a good night's sleep. Entertainment Tonight at 7.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the program. The sex scandals that are making the headlines these days do not involve politicians or the clergy for a change. Right now, the tawdry brush is tarring the world of professional sports. So from baseball to boxing, hoops to hockey, the news on the sports pages has never been this hot. Meet Rita. Rita was allegedly forced to have sex with perhaps the most powerful man in the world of professional wrestling, and she'll tell us all about it. Joining Rita is Murray Hodgson. Murray was an announcer in that same World Wrestling Federation until, like Rita, he also encountered alleged sexual harassment at the hands of WWF officials. Now, Rita, you were one of the first referees, female referees, in the WWF.
I am the first and still only in the country, to the best of my knowledge.
So you got between these two hulks and kept them apart and kept the game going.
Yeah.
As the first woman to break into that previously all-male area, you certainly stood the chance of making it very, very big, becoming a celebrity in a business, because wrestling obviously is more business than sport, in a business where the celebrities really do generate substantial income. What were the promises made to you by WWF officials?
The first day that I had met Vince McMahon, the first day in his office.
Vince McMahon is the owner of
the WWF.
Okay. There he is, a familiar face to anyone with a TV.
Yeah, Vince McMahon, what Vince says goes. That's the way it is.
Nice dimple, Vince.
I was offered a $500,000 a year contract. I was told that I was going to be so big, my name would be a household item. Everyone would know who I was. His exact words were, "How are you going to feel the first time you walk past a newsstand and see your face on the cover of Time magazine?" I mean, he just blew it up to be so unbelievable, you know? But I knew it was possible because I was a novelty. I was the only female.
There came a time when you and Vince McMahon were allegedly, I stress allegedly because he denies that you were allegedly in a limousine. Tell us what happened.
After a period of time, Vince and all his promises, I was getting less and less work. I'd try to call the Federation, try calling Vince to find out why, and I could never get through to him. I knew the only way that I could really get to Vince was to go to Poughkeepsie, which at the time is where they filmed all the all the television matches.
Poughkeepsie in upstate New York.
In upstate New York, mm-hmm. Yeah. I went to Poughkeepsie. I seen Vince in the hall. I had asked him if I could speak with him. He told me at that point that he was really busy, but after the matches to follow him to a restaurant. There's a Greek diner a few miles up the road. And I did. I got to the diner. Vince was there, his limo driver, four or five cameramen, other people, and myself were sitting at a big round table. They were talking what they were going to put on the show that week, what they were going to cut, a lot of technical things that I really didn't know anything about. When it seemed as though they were done talking, I brought up my career with Vince and asked, you know, what was going to happen here. And Vince just kind of looked at me, put his finger up to his mouth, and kind of did a, you know, hush, hush. So, of course, I did. I mean, Vince is, he's it. He makes you or breaks you. A few minutes later, I went into the ladies' room. When I come out into the corridor of the ladies' room, Vince was standing there, told me that he definitely wanted to talk to me about my career, said that he definitely neglected doing something with me at this point, and that he wanted me to follow him because he didn't want to talk there at the diner. There were quite a few people from the Federation there. It made sense. I can understand that. We left there. I followed Vince over to a Denny's in a parking lot. I got out of my car, walked to the front of the car. Vince's driver got out and opened the door, and I thought Vince was going to get out. But instead, Vince said to me, "No, Rita, come in here." He says, "We just sat in a diner for a couple hours. I really don't want coffee." He says, "We'll just sit and talk here." We're sitting in a parking lot. I mean, I didn't think much of it. I got in the limo with him. We got into the limo, Vince started talking about magazines, t-shirts, wrestling dolls. We don't have a referee doll at this point. A female would be great. On and on and on. again starts talking about a $500,000 a year contract. Next thing I know, Vince McMahon is unzipping his pants. I was pretty shocked at that point. I mean, we're talking profession here, and suddenly he wants more than just profession. Vince continued to, you know, if you want a $500,000 contract, you're going to have to satisfy me, and this is the way things have to go. Vince grabbed my hand, kept trying to put my hand on him. I was scared. My wrist, at the end, my wrist was all purple, black and blue. Things just didn't, he just didn't stop. This man just didn't stop, you know? A $500,000 a year contract. How's your daughter gonna go to college? Of course, she doesn't have to go to college. You know, now, I left a $30,000 a year job on Vince McMahon's word. He knew that.
What is your allegation, Rita? State it.
My allegation right now is sexual harassment. I was forced into oral sex with Vince McMahon. When I couldn't complete his desires, he got really angry, started ripping off my jeans, pulled me on top of him, and told me, again, if I wanted a $500,000 a year contract, I had to satisfy him. He could make me or break me, and if I didn't satisfy him, I was blackballed. That was it. I was done. When Vince was all said and done, Vince just sat back and said, at one point when I first met Vince, let me back up here just a little bit. The very first time I met Vince, I was told that if I had any sexual relationships with anyone in the Federation, I was done. My career was done. I was engaged. I had no problem with that. When Vince was said and done, Vince looked at me and said, do you remember what I told you about having sexual relationships with anyone? Well, you just did. And he just sat back and had this big smile and this big grin and just started laughing at me.
We'll get much deeper into Rita's allegations and talk with Murray about his harassment. Briefly, Murray, why don't you just say what one World Wrestling Federation official said when he saw you for the first time after you had been hired?
He approached me at the TV taping and he asked me what I taste like. I was somewhat offended by it and knew exactly what he wanted and told him that he had the wrong guy. And he candidly told me if I wanted to keep my job, that was the way it was going to be. I turned him down. 2 weeks later, I was fired.
We'll hear more on Murray's allegations. Let me just finish introducing you to the panel that will lead us through the next hour of these charges. Dominique Wilkins, he's one of the greats, one of the all-time greats. He plays for the Atlanta Hawks basketball team. He spotted Elizabeth here standing in line at a club one night. They dated for what, about a year?
A year,
okay. But when Elizabeth got pregnant, Elizabeth got dumped by Dominique. Is that about the way it happened?
Yeah, we had a real, what I thought was a real good relationship. We dated for a year, and as soon as he found out I was pregnant, he stopped calling. When I called his house, he wasn't home. He'd tell people to tell me he'd left town. It just went on and on to the point where I just could not get in contact with him. He finally told his mother, Miss Baker, that I was pregnant. She called me on Christmas Day and cursed me out on the telephone.
What did she call you?
What did she call you? Every foul mouth word you could think of. She told me that she would kill me before I ever got a dime from Dominique.
Did she call you a gold digger?
Yeah, she called me a gold digger. Although I had what I thought was a good relationship with Miss Baker. We talked, we call each other on the phone, we joke around, and all of a sudden on Christmas Day I get a phone call saying, not my son.
Were you a groupie, a basketball groupie?
No. Mm-mm. Dominique had groupies. He had a group of about 5-6 girls that were basically there for him at his beck and call. And I was not a groupie. I didn't even wasn't aware of these girls until I had broken up with him, because when you're dating Dominique, you're kept very isolated. No one tells you what's going on. No one tells you that he's fooling around with somebody. You're very isolated. They don't tell you anything.
There are, I should mention, just as Elizabeth suggests, a whole cadre, evidently, of young women who do nothing but hang around the players of the National Basketball Association. Will have someone, an expert who's done a lot of research in the area, out in the next segment to tell us more about that. I'm holding a document, a paternity testing report form from the American Red Cross Blood Services, the Atlanta region. The child is Chloe. How old is Chloe now?
8 months.
8 months, okay. The probability, I'll quote, the probability that Dominique Wilkins is the father of Chloe J. Webster is 99.79%. as opposed to a random man of the same risk.
He denied knowing me.
He denied knowing you.
I was in law school while I was dating him. Everybody in the law school had seen him. My friends had met him. He denied knowing me. Not only did he deny knowing me, but he denied knowing anybody who went to that school. He just outright denied me.
Has he ever seen the child?
Yeah, after I took him to court, okay. he saw her.
All right, you tell us much more about that as we go on. This is this month's Penthouse has Ivana Trump on the cover. Jasmine here is a Penthouse pet. Now, she was scheduled to pose for the cover of this month's Penthouse magazine with baseball's bad boy, Jose Canseco. But she claims that Jose wanted more than just her picture. Is that about right?
Yes, that's right.
What did he want, do you allege?
Well, I think he thought I was going to be a easy person to get in the bed with him. He had called me at midnight to come over to his house to play dominoes.
Dominoes?
Yeah, really, I'm
How
serious.
Quaint. And I don't think I ever used that one. Dominoes. To see my etchings, maybe, but dominoes. No.
And anyway, we were supposed to shoot the cover the next day, you know, and I was tired, so, you know, I told him no, and I had a boyfriend anyway. And then, like, you know, 10 minutes later, I got another phone call, and it was him again, asking me to come over to his house to play dominoes. So, you know, I told him no, and that was the end of it. And so then the next day, we were supposed to shoot the cover at like 3 in the afternoon, and we got a phone call like at noon from his agent saying that he had changed his mind about shooting the cover because he had reconciled with his wife. So in between midnight and noon, he had reconciled with his wife and played dominoes, too.
I guess. Now, Jasmine, you take your clothes off for a living.
Right, I'm a dancer.
And you're very shapely. What are your measurements? You can...
38, 24, 36.
Do you spend a lot of time hanging around professional ball players of one sort or another?
No, I had no idea who Jose Canseco was. I hate baseball, personally. you know, but when they
told
me...
Are you a groupie?
No. No way. No.
Has any other player ever approached you with an offer of money?
Yeah, a lot of times. I work in a club in Atlanta. And,
a topless kind of place?
Yeah. Yeah, and
I mean, you can understand why people might approach you.
Yeah, but it's the people that mostly approach you are, you know, athletes because they have a lot of money and they think with their money they can get whatever they want.
Okay, let's talk much more about that. Let me introduce our audience to Tiffany. Tiffany dates players in a different sport. Her beaus come from the National Hockey League. Now, despite the fact that most of the players are married, Tiffany does not consider herself a groupie. Tiffany obviously is not her real name. She's in disguise. She doesn't want to... Why? Are you embarrassed by what you do, Tiffany?
For the security of myself, my family, and the acquaintances that I have in the NHL, their security.
Now, how do the players arrange their dates with you?
I call them. They call me. I see them. They may say, Tiffany will be in such and such in a week. Can you drive over and meet me?
Do they pay you for your voyages?
That would be the exception, not the rule.
But it has happened?
It has.
Are you, forgive me for being blunt, a hooker?
Oh, no, no. And I don't mean paying in the respect that you mean.
Oh, but okay, you can tell us all about it. I've got to take my first commercial break. It is sex scandals of the season, playing ball, the focus of this edition of Geraldo.
You know, they say all good things must come to an end. And life began here at Rock Springs Vista at just 54,950. And it's going to end at 65,950. We're beginning construction on our final phase of our famous two-bedroom, two-bath condominium. That's it. Zip. Zero. Nada. No moss. So if you want a Rock Springs Vista condominium, this may be your last chance. A fat lady's about to sing.
I shopped at Vons and used the double coupons.
Lucky's doesn't have double coupons. Vons does.
Vons gives double coupons and Lucky doesn't.
It surprised me how much I saved with Vons.
I saved almost $6.
I saved more money at Vons.
I knew before I did the survey that Vons offered double coupons, but I never knew I'd save as much as I did.
How much can you save with Vons double coupons? Compare for yourself, because the only price survey that really counts is yours.
Pennies on the dollar. That's what the insurance company would like to give the victim of an accident.
I'm Carl Piazza. You know, insurance companies have to protect their interests, not yours. They want you to settle quickly and sign away your rights. At Carl Piazza & Associates, we help thousands of accident victims get every dollar of compensation they deserve. If you've been injured, we'll go to work for you, and with no fee until you collect.
Carl Piazza & Associates, because you need the kind of help that makes dollars and cents.
This weight loss program offers a solution you can live with, total flexibility and savings.
I love it, and I feel great. I lost 56 pounds eating three good meals a day. I could eat at restaurants, even fast food outlets. I like the flexibility. I even saved money. I lost weight, but my grocery bill stayed the same.
Slim down for summer. Get 75% off all programs. Our best offer ever at American Weight Loss. Call now, American Weight Loss Centers.
Sex scandals of the season. Playing ball out there today. Before I introduce you to the panel of experts, let me just take a couple of questions. Yeah.
I want to know to Dominique, if you...
That's Elizabeth. Dominique
I'm sorry,
is...
Yeah. I'm sorry. If you collect child support from the basketball player...
Yeah. I took him to court and I won the court case.
And what was the child support and did he pay it?
I can't disclose the amount, but he is now paying erratically.
So I heard, you can't disclose, I heard it was $2,600 a month, but then he only paid for 2 months.
I can't.
But now, have you, okay, she can't.
I'd just like to ask a question of this woman who's been said that she's been raped by three baseball players in Florida. Why does she wait a whole year for this to come out? What, you know, that's the question that's been bothering me throughout this whole thing.
I think that Rita is probably the most relevant person to answer that. Rita, of course, the woman who has claimed that Vince McMahon forced her, number one, to perform oral sex and then raped her in the backseat of his limousine. Rita, when did it happen?
This happened July 15th, 1986.
So here you have a situation where 6 years has passed since the alleged encounter. That, of course, is Mr. McMahon's strongest defense, Rita. If it really happened, why did you wait?
Well, I can't answer her question as far as the Mets and what happened
there. No, but I want you to speak for yourself on the question of delay.
What happened with me is, at that time, you people don't understand wrestling. Nobody talks, for one. No one talks. It's a complete hush-hush world. I did go to see an attorney. I was told at that time that basically this was going to come down to my word against his because I had no proof. I had to weigh that. At the time, my mother was on oxygen 24 hours a day. My dad had a bad heart. And I didn't think either one of my parents could have been put through it, especially at that time where no one was opening up. Everything was so quiet.
One of the things that we found, Rita, and this is to you and Murray, is that the World Wrestling Federation, like any big business, when confronted with an allegation or a scandal, does have the capacity to put it maybe harshly, buy off potential complainants. Were you ever offered a cash settlement?
I wasn't offered a cash settlement, no.
Murray, were you?
Blatantly, yeah. He tried to buy me off so I wouldn't come forward and tell her the allegations. He feared repercussions.
And how much were you offered?
I don't want to discuss that.
They don't want to discuss it. I heard it was $160,000.
Well, that's what he claims, but...
Tiffany, what's the attraction of these hockey players to you? Why? If it's not money, why?
It's a fast-paced, exciting sport. I've known a lot of people within the league for a number of years, and it's just the circle of friends that I've come accustomed to.
Oh, Tiffany, come on. It's not the sport. I mean, you're not a play-by-play announcer. You're seeing them after the game, so is it something about them as young men, hard bodies? What is it?
It's always been a little exciting, yes.
I mean, how do they treat you? Do they treat you as a woman to be respected? Do they use you and abuse you?
Respect, most definitely. I think a lot of sports athletes these days, I can only speak for sure within the National Hockey League, but I'm assuming throughout the other leagues, I think most sports athletes these days get a bum rap, so to speak. No offense to anyone here. I'm sure these allegations took place, but for the most part, I've found them nothing but gentlemen and very kind and caring.
Kind and caring to you? You're a woman of some experience. How many NHL players have you been with? Now, come on, give us the real number.
I've been with several people within the organization.
Now, I heard that your goal was to be with one person from every team in the league.
No. You heard absolutely incorrectly. I think you're referring...
Just the Patrick division?
No. No, I think what you're referring to actually is the 22 Club, which is a club that has...
The 22 Club?
Yes.
Which That's is how many teams are in the league?
Yes, currently.
That's right. When they expand, we'll bring you back. You can give us an update. No. Go. E. Jean Carroll is one of my favorite writers in America. She's very, very talented. She wrote an article featured in this month's Esquire magazine. There it is, Love in the Time of Magic. Alluding to the Magic Johnson story, of course, but also reporting on the phenomenon of sports groupies, specifically in the National Basketball Association. Now, Jean, because of her unusual perspective on these things, believes that these girls get a bad rap, do you?
Oh, yeah. If I were Tiffany, I'd take off your hat and take off your wig. I think these women are pioneer feminists of their time. I think that they're throwing aside the social conventions that are confining women. They're going after what they want. They see these men. These men are rich. They don't do drugs. They don't smoke. They don't do anything. What they do is they have fun with women. So these women are going after what they want. I think they're...
Aren't they being slutty?
No. What they're doing is they're behaving like men have behaved for thousands of years.
Touché. We'll be right back. Sports scandals of the season. Our focus. Stay tuned.
When you have a corn, the bigger it gets, the smaller your shoe feels. And that can be extremely painful. Fortunately, Dr. Scholl's corn removers relieve painful corns fast. Clinically proven, safe, and effective. First, they cushion the pain. Then they dissolve the corn within 5 applications or less. Guaranteed. So buy Dr. Scholl's corn removers and get back into things.
Careful. Lovely.
What do you think?
I think I'd like a Diet Dr. Pepper.
Diet Dr. Pepper tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper. When you want one, there's no stopping the taste.
Smelly, rotten mildew stains? Try X14. It's better. Compare 3 sprays of Tilex to just 1 spray of X14. In minutes, the X14 site is dramatically cleaner without scrubbing. Try X14. It's better.
What would you do if another woman buried your husband and didn't tell you? Or better yet, if your dead husband showed up on your doorstep? Revealing grave secrets, bizarre stories of death and deception next to Geraldo.
This is my new Dodge Caravan. Dad says it costs under $14,300. Mom says it's a great deal with air conditioning at no extra charge when you buy the Family Value Package. It's safe, too. With the driver's airbag, rear seat shoulder harnesses, you can even get available built-in child seats. Maybe that's why Caravan is the number one selling minivan in America.
See your local Dodge dealer, where you can rediscover American value.
Michael E. Minden is proud to unveil the Minden Double Twist. Now you can own two rings in one. Choose from hundreds of combinations, including pink ice, birthstones, mother's rings, diamond designs, and diamond initials. Create your perfect combination from only $199. It's the Minden Double Twist. And now 14-karat graduated rope comes together with your choice of ruby, emerald, or sapphires with diamonds in a bracelet for $169 or earrings for $139.
Michael E. Minden and Company Jewelers.
East Sunset Road, one block east of Green Valley Parkway.
Venga a disfrutar.
You need to do it!
I fight fires, so I keep myself in top shape. My life might depend on it.
Join now you for 90 days it. For only $60.
But don't just do it! Do it right!
Family Fitness Centers of Las Vegas.
Do it right!
I'm Melody Swanson. If you were injured due to a motor vehicle accident as a pedestrian or a bicyclist, there could be more than one avenue of recovery for you. My past experience as in-house counsel for a major insurance company and defense counsel for several insurance carriers has proven to benefit my personal injury clients over the past 7 years. Don't base your decision solely upon advertisements. Let my experience provide you the representation you deserve. Free written information about my qualifications and experience is a phone call away. Call my office.
Sal Marciano, everybody. Sal Marciano, a sportscaster who has seen it all. He says that these guys sometimes do take things a little far, but they are easy targets for scandal, and they are being, in some cases at least, victimized. First of all, Sal, what do you think about Gene said about why not let these girls do what they do? It's something the guys have been doing for years.
I kind of agree with that. In the last 25 years of covering New York sports on television and five before that on radio, I found most professional athletes to be spoiled brats sexually. Remember this, that when they're teenagers, they have the co-eds and the pom-pom girls who want to be with them. And then, of course, when they become professionals, they're in the minor leagues, the women come at them as the lure is that maybe I can hitch up to this guy and get married. And let me just say this. I do not condone sexual harassment, and I'm certainly not for people fathering children and not taking care of their responsibilities. But the average athlete, when he's in his late teens, early 20s, is very promiscuous, and it's easy for him to get women. It happens in the minor leagues and the major leagues. I'll tell you a story. I can't tell you the ball player. He's a household name. You must sometimes wonder what they say at first base. This very famous ball player got a single one night, and the first baseman told me the story. He said the famous player said to him, he said, "Hey, come here, I want to tell you something." He said, "You know, my wife's sitting behind our dugout, but my girlfriend is sitting behind the other dugout." The first baseman said, "Big deal, that's nothing new to that. You know, I've heard that before." And he said, "Yeah, but the one they don't know about is sitting behind home plate." That shows you
that's
the arrogance.
Covering the bases. That's
yeah.
I was upset by, I guess, Jean Carroll's remark, being a woman and considering myself a feminist, that why do women think to get ahead they have to go for men with money and it has to be sex involved? And I think that's why this first woman took so many years to come forward, because we as women feel that we can only get ahead through sex, and I disagree with that. That's putting us back 20 years.
Putting us ahead 1,000 years. I'm not saying that they have to go out and do it. I'm saying it can be an option for anyone. As a matter of fact, I think half the audience, after we're through here, should go down to Shea Stadium or out to Yankee Stadium. Women shouldn't be confined. We shouldn't be kept home as vegetables. We should be just as sexually free as these athletes are. And
well, shouldn't they hang out at the NYU Medical Center and meet some doctors as well?
They can do that too. It's just, I think
that I think
the scandal about the ball players is people are worried that these quote unquote groupies are sucking like vampires all their testosterone out of these players, and therefore they're backed by a lot of money and they want these teams to
win.
Well,
that's exactly right. And that's what's changed. Nothing has changed the last 25 years except the player's salary. Last month in West Palm Beach, covering the Mets and the Braves, I interviewed women who had hitchhiked from all over the South to meet a Braves player. One woman said she wants to sleep with every member of the team. Another woman said to me, we're looking for hard bodies and big bucks. And it's the seven-figure salaries. That's the difference.
It's not all fun and games. At the University of Oklahoma, which is, it may be a college football team, but it's about as close to the NFL you're going to get for young students. Back in the 80s, the young women would be coming into the dorm. They would be raped by 12, 13 different football players. Charges weren't even pressed for whatever reasons. Finally, about 1989, three players went to jail. But that, it's not fun in games all the time.
It isn't. Alan Schoenstein, the editor of Penthouse. Yes.
My question's for Tiffany. I wanted to know if any of the men that she sees are married.
Majority of them.
The majority are married.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you feel about that, Tiffany?
I don't want to make it sound, you said that I see, that I have seen, actually, is a better accurate description. I've seen a few people over the years, and
why
not? I have a girlfriend who dates only policemen, and another one that dates only attorneys, and this isn't solely exclusive to them,
but I have
friends in the league. I'm not looking for a commitment at the moment, and this is a safe way of not getting committed.
Who are better, goalies or like wingmen?
Time out! Time out! I'm Morgana the Kissing Man. And you know what to do with that handsome cheek. Give me that cheek. I got things for you. I got some Kissing Band of peanuts. Just a moment, I have to reach into my secret hiding spot. I have one of my baseball cards for you. Here, who likes peanuts? Get your Kissing Band of peanuts. You gotta eat those.
Oh, I get the hot ones. All right, thanks. Morgana, the Kissing Bandit, what a surprise. How are you doing?
How much do you need to purchase one of these fine used cars? Or how about one of these fine used cars? Only at the biggest little car lot in town, Eastern Avenue Motors at Eastern and Sahara.
I'm gonna get thin, my wallet's gonna get fat.
Introducing the Jenny Craig Weight Loss Rebate.
The rebate? It's what got me here.
We pay you a dollar for every pound you've lost once you reach your goal weight.
96 pounds, $96.
41 pounds, $41 back.
I'm gonna be this big in a skirt that short.
Go shopping, what more could you ask for?
Jenny Craig Weight Loss Centers. Call today.
This is Las Vegas. If you've been injured in an accident here, there are 12 reasons you should call David Allen and Associates. Reason number two, experience. 20 years ago, I was on the other side teaching insurance people how to evaluate and negotiate their own cases. Knowing how that other side works is a big, big advantage for your side. Call us, David Allen and Associates. The consultation is free, the information invaluable.
Outspoken, outrageous Rush Limbaugh. Is he the most dangerous man in America? Find out next Donahue.
Today at 4 on Channel 8. It's finally here, a fresh, innovative concept in morning news. Eyewitness News This Morning. Southern Nevada's first one-hour morning newscast with the latest news, weather, and traffic updates every 15 minutes. Finally, news when you want it, when you need it. Start your day with Eyewitness News This Morning at 6 a.m. only on Channel 8, Southern Nevada's 24-hour news source.
surprise visitor dropping in here at the broadcast center during baseball's opening week, Morgana the Kissing Bandit.
Geraldo, before we start talking about Jose Canseco and some of the other players, and let's face it, Jose has been a little on the wild side ever since he allegedly kissed Madonna. So, I mean, that's true. He has been a little wild. But before we start talking about that, I brought something here for Mike. You know,
Mike Jacobs, our stage
ladies
manager.
Ladies and gentlemen, sports fans,
still looking for a date for last New Year's Eve. But
that's right. Please close your eyes because I do have to go up my skirt because I only have two hands and I had peanuts and stuff I was carrying. So close your eyes while I get Mike's gift out, his little sports souvenir. And it says Morgana the Kissing Bandit. Now you can hang this on your rearview mirror. There you go.
Hi, my name, my question's for Tiffany. What, aren't you afraid in this day and age of getting AIDS or anything, contacting AIDS?
No, I'm not. As I said in the past, majority of the men that I've dated have been married, and that also gives me a sense of security because I know they've only been with one person.
I think that was my biggest.
If they're sleeping with,
yeah.
If they're sleeping with you, what makes you think they're not sleeping with other people?
Yeah.
Oh, it's very possible. No, it's very possible. Precautions are taken, most definitely, and it's very possible. And whether they see someone else or not is irrelevant.
I really don't care.
But the gentlemen that I have seen have been over a period of years. It's been the same gentleman. It hasn't been one here and one there.
Okay, I just have a comment to make. Number one, what the lady that next to Sal Marciano said is true. Okay, that women are doing what men have been doing for hundreds of years. And just a comment shortly on why maybe some of these rapes occur now. We, the public, put them up there on the pedestal. Too much money, too much fame. They have a lot of people in their camp to help them clean up when they make their little messes. So they start to feel godlike and feel that they're above all of these things and punishment. And then when they have groupies and things throwing themselves at them, then they feel all females are that way.
My question is directed to Elizabeth. I wonder if she discussed family planning with...
For me?
Yes.
Well, I know, I can't really go into detail.
How'd you get pregnant? I mean, we know how you got pregnant. Why did you get pregnant, I guess?
Why?
Yeah.
Well, I was using...
Were you trying to trap Dominique Wilkins?
No, I wasn't trying to trap Dominique Wilkins. And that's another point that I would like to get on is that the girls get a bad rap in the sense that the public is led to think that we're trying to trap them, that we're after their money, we want this, and they fail to realize that these men lead the woman on. They lead them to think they want serious long-term relationships, that they're in love with them, that they care about them, that they'll go that last mile. And then when something like that, when you do get pregnant, happens, they're not there for you.
Gene is...
Why does he have to think about family planning?
Right.
Why couldn't he, you know?
He never used anything. I mean, and as far
he
as...
He used something.
No, well, as far as what Tiffany says, she's not afraid of catching AIDS. I can't even believe that.
You know what women need to use? Common sense. I think that would take care of the whole deal, you know?
Morgana, were you ever, I know your routine, and obviously you are a very bodacious person. Now you're a baseball team owner and everything, but were you ever a groupie?
Oh, no. I only kissed him on the cheek, and I'm gone. I've kissed over 100 athletes. Of course, I've never slept with anyone because I'm a Republican, you know, so we just...
Jean Carroll, I wonder if, are most of the women like Elizabeth, are they looking for serious relationships? The ladies that you interviewed, they seemed more frivolous, more into the experience in the short term.
I think the women that I talk to are philosophers. I think their philosophy of life is the Darwinian theory. They wanted the tallest, the strongest, the handsomest, the richest. They themselves were beautiful, soft, they were in great shape. They spent as much time in the gym as the Lakers did. They're after it because these are the finest men walking around. Why should they go any lower than that? I mean, why would they... why would they look at an accountant when they could be looking at these really exquisite, artistic, athletic, powerful men?
Rich superstars.
And rich superstars.
Plus, they have to be handsome. It's in their contract, so that, I think, is what lures women into.
And also very immature.
But in defense of the ball players, especially baseball, if it doesn't involve whipped cream or shaving cream, they did not do it, ladies. Let me tell you. Because everything baseball players do, I don't care if it's from putting shaving cream on the top of each other's ball caps to filling their beds up with whipped cream. You know, a case of whipped cream, ball players have this thing for cans of cream. Ask Dave Cohn. Well, I mean, he's a
ball
player.
Dave Cohn is the New York Met who's currently charged with, exposing himself, Sal?
May I use the
There's a lawsuit
term?
Brought against him that he exposed himself. That's has to be proven as yet.
Civil suit, right.
Yeah, I think he's finding out that celebrity is a two-sided coin and that his popularity with the women of New York is also has a bad side to it.
I want to ask Jasmine, I never really got the whole story of what happened with the athlete who propositioned you with money. How much money was it?
Well, he gave me $2,000 in my hand. And offered me more than that to come home with him.
At least he didn't think she was cheap.
Let's take a break on that note. Six scandals of the season. Our focus, baseball's opening week. But the news isn't all on the field, is it?
I'm Stanley Square, a quality square foot. Now you can experience the thrill of condominium living at Verde Viejo for yourself and your car. We call it Verde Nugan. Drive out Warm Springs just east of Green Valley Parkway and get a Verde Viejo condo from just $76,450. Verde Nugan is extra. Get behind the door of a Verde Viejo condo with a garage, and I'll throw in a Stanley garage door opener. Drive out today, and I'll get the door for you. I'm Stanley Square, a quality square foot. If you haven't seen the new condos at Verde Viejo, you're in for a real treat because we're introducing Verde Nugan. Drive east on Warm Springs, just east of Green Valley Parkway, and experience the thrill of owning a new condo from just $76,450. Buy a Verde Viejo condo with a garage, that's Verde Nugan, and I'll throw in a Stanley garage door opener. Whoop, wrong prop. Oh well, tell them you saw it on TV.
If you need legal representation in a personal injury case, call Bruce Anderson, attorney at law. Handling all personal injury cases, including auto and motorcycle accidents, defective products, slip and fall, and wrongful death, Bruce Anderson will handle your case personally and get you the best result possible. Don't go it alone. Call today. Attorney Bruce Anderson for legal representation in personal injury, criminal defense, and family law. Call 598-2029.
This man's looking for pigeons. And he just found one. He steals phone calling card numbers. But she's seen this before on CNBC.
Calling card thieves.
Watch CNBC every night for information that hits home and see what's happening before it happens to you. CNBC. Watch it tonight. Use it tomorrow.
Six scandals of the season. Playing ball, whether voluntarily or being forced into it. Now, Rita, I know that we got the buildup as to your very ill parents as one of the reasons why you waited 6 years to go public on your charge of sexual harassment. And indeed, the essence of the charge. But specifically, was it your parents? Is that why you waited?
That was part of the reason, yes. My parents are both dead now. My dad passed away a month ago. No one would believe me if I came through with this 7 years ago. If I tried talking about it, no one would have believed me. And that's the way it is because no one would have talked.
And what about you, Murray? Why did you keep your mouth shut if it wasn't for the $160,000?
Well, I came forward immediately when I was fired. I retained an attorney and we had consulted with Mr. McMahon about the advance immediately. He'd just been denying everything. I didn't wait 1 minute. I had a 2-year contract with the company, and inside of 2 months, because I wouldn't sleep with the vice president, they threw me out on the street. We wasted no time in going after him.
Is homosexuality, do you allege, rampant in the WWF?
Well, I don't want to necessarily say homosexuality. Let's just say that sexual harassment is indeed just tearing through the internal corrosion of the World Wrestling Federation. And nobody's ever wanted to say anything. It gets right down to the fact where there was alleged child sex abuse. Yeah, and the problem was, Mr. McMahon is so powerful, he has so much money, he stopped that lawsuit before it had an opportunity to get to court.
Don't they allege that you're trying to blackmail them into giving them a larger settlement?
Why would I need to blackmail somebody when I have a legitimate 2-year contract? They flew me in back and forth 5 different times from Detroit. Vince McMahon held a national talent search looking for one guy.
Are you employed now?
No. I'm working part-time.
Elizabeth, does Dominique Wilkins have any other children from women he met in a similar
situation? He was sued previously with his older daughter, Aisha. It's paternity and child support. He also denied her and denied knowing the mother. Same thing.
Rita, what do you expect to get now? I mean, it's been 6 years now, so what do you want? Did you just want to come on Geraldo, or...?
What do I want? I want people to understand what's really happening there. You know, if you had a brother that went into wrestling...
That, though, 7 years ago, you could have did that. You could have been the first. There has
you're
to be
right.
a first
You're
somewhere.
Right. I
you
could have done that 7 years person. Ago. You're absolutely right. 7 years ago, my mother was on oxygen 24 hours a day, and my dad had a bad heart. After talking to the attorney...
I think it should also be said, talking about Rita's case, that many people have come forward to disclose all the sexual harassment that's been going on within the World Wrestling Federation. People in groups are coming forward. We're talking about wrestlers, employees, and now referees as well.
Jasmine, what sport was the $2,000 offer?
Baseball.
A baseball player?
Yeah.
Someone we would know?
Yes.
What position?
Well, he plays for the White Sox.
The farm team. I played under the farm team for the White Sox.
Well, hey, I was at White Sox training camp. It's great, great organization.
You know what, Jasmine had a problem with Jose Canseco.
Go ahead.
Nobody has ever said no to Jose Canseco. When Jose Canseco came to the hotel room, he had about 12 people with him. Jose doesn't receive his own phone calls, doesn't make his own phone calls. To this day, he has never called me to tell me why he really didn't show up for the photo shoot. This was a photo shoot where he knew we brought two photographers in from Los Angeles. I came down from New York. Jasmine came up from Atlanta. Cost a lot of dollars. Jose Canseco's not concerned about other people's money
either. You think he's spoiled?
He's a spoiled brat, Jose Canseco.
Gene, are we giving sex a bad name?
No, you know, that this is. We've got to come out of our social confines. We should congratulate these women who are taking the first step and who are leading the rest of the women on our way. We've got to leave our...
Come on, I want to talk to someone. One of my guests, I have some people here from Omaha. Stand up for one sec. Here, stand up. Now, what do you think of what she's proposing here, that the ladies should be proud of seeking out these athletes and bedding them?
Well, I don't think they should be proud of them. I wouldn't want to be proud of anybody seeking them out and bed them.
Don't you think that she's flying in the face of conventional mores?
Well, I guess so.
Well, I just want everybody to know that I'm not a groupie of any kind. I've just been approached by many professional ball players because of the work I do.
That's the key word, approach. A lot of times these women don't approach the athletes. They approach the woman. They pick them out of the crowd. They get their friends to come and get them. I mean, they literally scan crowds and pick these women out.
But they don't have to say yes. I mean, it's a compliment. I flew in today with the Romanian wrestling team, by the way. Nice flight you put me on. Me and about 50 guys, all Romanian wrestlers.
I'm sure you loved it. You probably kissed everyone.
They went, ooh, baby, baby. But it's kind of cute. And I said, hey, big boy, maybe I'll give you a call sometime. You know, you kid with them. They're just fun, like Sal said.
Yeah, but they don't kid when they're putting $2,000 in your hand and expect you to go.
All you got to do is lock your knees and say no thank you, you know?
I did turn them down, but why?
You know, I mean, we were put through a lot.
I don't know your situation. That's different, you know, if you were dating or what have you.
We were put through a lot by these men. I mean, I had to leave law school because of this whole situation.
Well, your situation, I think, is a little bit different. Come to think of it, though, Geraldo, I think I was once sexually harassed by the whole New York Yankees dugout. Now I have to decide whether to sue or to kiss them. I just cannot decide.
You can laugh about that, but Tiffany, see, look in that camera. Just look at Chris's camera there. See, there's the wife of the last guy you were with. What are you going to tell her?
As long as her husband doesn't have a problem. I overheard one wife say once, I know what he does when he's not home, but at least he comes home to me, and that's all that matters. And what Elizabeth said here, to a point, is absolutely correct, that the players do go after the women. But what I have seen for the majority, I have seen women purposely track down players to gain
Don't you have tremendous competition for each player?
Excuse me?
Don't you have tremendous competition for each and every player?
I have no competition. No, I've seen the type of people. I mean, they hang out in the bars. They hang out after the games. They're in the motel. They're very high profile. I've seen girls practically do anything to get to them.
Could this be the existential essence as to why sexual harassment is starting
Darwinian
to get crazier?
Darwinian theory, existentialism, boy, that's a pretty...
I think it's important to note that as more and more people succumb to their employer's sexual wishes, it makes them feel more powerful, and that they feel they're so strong that they can have sex with anybody and don't dare try to stop us.
Jasmine, what's the name of the club that you play in?
I'll be at Tiffany's Cabaret in Phoenix, Arizona, all this week.
All this week, okay. Mm-hmm. So people down in Phoenix, Arizona can catch Phoenix, Jasmine right? at Tiffany's Cabaret. Thanks, we'll be right back.
What's in the box?
It's cakes, can't you tell?
Is it good?
Yeah, very good.
Has it got any marshmallows?
Nah.
Sugar frosting?
Nope.
Well, what's in it? I'm hungry.
You'll see.
What Kix has is a corn crunch that kids like. And Kix is low in sugar. That's what moms like.
It's good.
Yeah, but they're very hard to open.
Yeah.
Kix. Kid tested. Mother approved.
We asked Maureen Waldron why she switched from Murphy Oil Soap to Pledge Household Cleaner.
There is a big difference. I don't have time to put into rinsing my house. But with the Pledge Household Cleaner, I didn't have to rinse it off. It's just a smooth, clean feeling. So if I can cut out 20 minutes with Pledge Household Cleaner, then that's an additional 20 minutes I can spend with my baby, which is important.
Pledge Household Cleaner gently cleans all your household surfaces beautifully. From S.C. Johnson Wax.
It's going to be Pledge.
Speak up, America. We want to hear your comments and show ideas. Give us a call at 1-900-SPEAK-UP. Let us know what you're thinking. We'll record your message to play in a future broadcast. We may even call you to be a guest on a show. So call 1-900-SPEAK-UP. Don't forget, the call costs $1. We'll be right back.
Stealth RT Turbo, 300 horsepower, 0 to 60 in under 5 seconds.
The little old lady from Pasadena.
Choose from 4 stealth models, one starting under $17,900.
See your local Dodge dealer, where you can rediscover American value.
Make your Easter dinner a memorable one with a delicious ready-to-serve honey-baked ham. It's fully cooked, then glazed with a rich blend of imported spices to seal in all that famous honey-baked flavor and tenderness. Honey-baked brand ham is the original spiral-sliced ham and is available only from your honey-baked store.
Located at 3585 South Maryland Parkway in Las Vegas.
Make it honey-baked for the best of times.
At Carl Piazza and Associates, you'll be listened to, you'll be helped, you'll be cared about.
I'm Carl Piazza. I know being the victim of an accident is frightening. There are so many things to cope with besides just getting well. Doctor and hospital bills, car repairs, your lost wages. At our office, we take the worry from you. We speak your language. We explain and help every step of the way. And there's no fee until you collect.
Carl Piazza and Associates, for answers in plain English or Spanish.
You might not realize it, but the weight of the world is on your draperies. Cooking odors, grease, and car exhaust take a heavy toll on drapery fibers. Pet hair, smoke, dust, and pollen are also a lot to absorb. Fortunately, Coit Cleaning can restore your draperies. With parallel pleats, even hems, and no shrinkage, Coit guarantees it in writing.
Call for Coit now and save 20% on drapery cleaning.
For value you can trust, call for Coit.
Sex scandals of the season. Focus. So, Sal, what do you think?
What do I think? I all the years of covering sports, lots of people meet, get married, have wonderful lives. It's not necessarily the bad stories we've heard. I think we should speak up for the great relationships that have flowered through travel and athletics.
Although that is definitely true. It's also true in the news business, but also in the news business, there are probably more divorces than marriages three to one. Are there more groupies now than ever before?
Yes, it's because of the money. It's definitely because of the seven figures. Ball players, the average, starting this season, the average major leaguer will earn $1 million, and that is a lure for people of the opposite sex.
What's the most Babe Ruth ever made?
Yeah, this guy right here.
I don't think he made that much.
$100,000.
Yes, Geraldo, my question is directed towards Tiffany. Tiffany, do you not have any major goals in life besides betting goalies?
Tiffany's gone. No. Oh, this is Tiffany. Oh, you're in disguise. I didn't recognize you. I'm sorry. I thought it was the blonde girl that...
Tiffany.
Somebody gave her $2,000.
I know. That is not a goal in life. No. No.
But what is, I mean, why do it? Is it because it feels good? If it's not even for money, I mean, why?
I just have acquired friends over the years, and these are my friends currently.
So they call you up and say, hi, I'll be in Toronto tomorrow. Can you drive up?
You know, it's one thing for people to go home and, in the biblical term, be together if they want to. But what gets me is the women who maybe have a drink with a player. The guy probably never even saw her again in his life. And a year later, they, you know, call out and say, I've been raped and what have you. You know, I mean, that's the part that gets me. It's one thing what two willing parties want to do. But this stuff, don't go home with three of the players, 45-minute drive, and then a year later say they raped me. Why would they have to rape them? I mean,
here we go. Morgana caps the segment. Give us a couple of minutes.
Overweight, injured, sick, tired of escalating medical costs. Dr. Elliot Turetsky, a licensed osteopathic physician in Las Vegas for over 15 years, offers rapid weight control office visits of $35 a month and include free chemical urinalysis, free vitamin B12 injections every visit, complete medical history, physical examinations, and a cheap and effective appetite suppressant prescription if needed. For most minor illnesses and injuries not covered by insurance, the fee is $25. Medicare accepted. Call Dr. Elliot Turetsky's message number, 593-0840.
A serious motorcycle accident could turn your life upside down, all because some driver wasn't looking. Look out for yourself. See a lawyer. At the law offices of David Stobling, we're experienced at handling serious motorcycle injuries. We'll represent you on a percentage basis. We don't get paid until we win your case. Call us at 734-1600 for a free personal consultation. At the law offices of David Stobling, we help injured people. We get results.
Is it on? Today, Wendy's is happy to announce a great low price on a new old-fashioned single combo. It's a quarter of a pound of fresh beef, hot off the grill, made just the way you want it. Plus, veggie fries that are really big, and you get your favorite 20-ounce drink. Now, that's what I call a real meal. What's more, you save a bundle.
Try Wendy's old-fashioned single combo, just $2.99 for a limited time.
Was it something I said?
Nobody does Easter like Smith's, because we have everything you and the kids need to decorate Easter eggs, including beautiful baskets to put them in. Plus, Smith's has a great selection of candy at terrific prices, like a four-pack of Cadbury cream eggs, just $1.19. And you'll make everyone happy with our large assortment of Easter plush. Easter goodies, available now at Smith's. We have a better way to run a supermarket and an Easter shop, too.
Accommodations for guests of the Geraldo Show were provided by the new luxury Ramada Renaissance Times Square Hotel at 48th Street and 7th Avenue, New York City. Promotional fees have been provided by...
I use the denture cleanser of the 90s, fast-acting denture foam. Deep cleans like tablets, fast like toothpaste, so you can quickly brush dentures clean. Denture foam, it deep cleans fast.
The Boss, the low-cost ESP from Eureka. It can cut your cleaning time in half. The Boss from Eureka, the power to sweep you off your feet.
Thank you.
I have two quick comments. Which are the women most interested in first, the man itself or his fame? And a quick question to the woman with the black hat on. You go into bed with these men who were married. Don't you think that if they're going to bed with you, that they have 10 other ones on the side too, and that AIDS would be prevalent?
Tiffany, are you in a group? I mean, you're not a groupie, but do you have lots of company?
No. I have dated a few friends on a regular basis.
And they see only you?
I don't know.
Jean, isn't it inevitable, as Sal suggests, that the women that you portray as relatively positive creatures...
Pioneers, Geraldo, pioneers.
Pioneers might develop the lean and hungry look when they think about the financial pot at the end of the rainbow?
I disagree with the panelists here. I think they think that women are after money, and I know that's not true. These women are after something else, and it has to do with the long thigh, the big chest. We're not talking about money. These women are just drawn. Every pore in their body is drawn to these men because it's sex, not money.
I want to thank all our panelists. Thank you so much for coming by. Rita, good luck to you. Thanks.
This 24-hour news break is brought to you by Vegas Instant Page. We keep you in touch.
And now, an Eyewitness News 8 update.
Eyewitness News at this hour, I'm Gary Waddell. A man apparently protesting nuclear testing pushed to the stage at the Hilton this afternoon, interrupted a speech by former President Ronald Reagan, and smashed a glass statue that had just been presented to the former president. You can see the man, who still hasn't been publicly identified, was wrestled from the stage. More on that.